Hi there! Welcome to this Origami Design tutorial where we'll be talking about scrollable boxes. Scrollable boxes are boxes that are bigger on the inside than on the outside. It appears on the stage as a box like this that is 256 by 256. If I double click on it, I go inside where you can see it's the same size. If I go back out and change the size of it to say 800 by 450, that sounds good. And I go back in, it's still the same size as before. So I'll set this to the same height as on the outside, but I want to be able to move horizontally inside of this box, so I'll set this one to 1,000. No, let's do 2,000. So now we can see it's way longer on the inside than on the outside, which means inside of this area I'll be able to move horizontally. Which is what I made. I'm just going to give this a little bit of color so you can see where we have it on the outside. So I have this page over here that I've been working on, which you can see it consists of two scrollables. If I go inside of it, you can see it's way longer vertically than on the outside, and I also have these anchors on the side that makes it snap to that point. So if I now go over to my iPad, I'll show you the same page, and you can see I am scrolling up and down on both of these scrollable boxes, and because I have anchors, they snap to the point. That's the very most basic version of using a scrollable box. If we go back here, you can see in the inspector that we have a couple of different ways of manipulating this scrollable box. We can set the direction to both, meaning you can go both vertically and horizontally, or just one of them. Speed 1 means that it'll move as fast as your finger. If you set it below 0, it'll move slower than your finger. If you go above, it'll move faster than your finger. Scroll groups, I'll go more into that in another tutorial, but it's basically a way of grouping your scrollable boxes together if you have more of them. Touch, if you set it to tracking, means that you can make it follow your finger. If you set it to none, it will not follow your finger, meaning you can't interact with it. Motion, you can control it to by the accelerometer or the gyroscope, so you can tilt your iPad to move the content of the scrollable box. Bounce means that when you get to the end of the box, it'll bounce out from the side instead of just stopping there, which gives a nice little effect. Wrap makes it so that when you get to the end, it'll start back at the beginning, so you'll go in a continuous loop. And push does it so that when you get to the end, you can go to the next page instead of just keep continuing to move that scrollable. Invert flips it upside down or back and forth, depending on which way you're going. So you can have two scrollable boxes in a scroll group, and you can make one go to the right and one go to the left if you want to do that. Scroll bar gives you that little nice Apple scroll bar that shows you where you are inside of it. And sloppy means that it'll move just a fraction slower than your finger right at the beginning. The scroll area lets you define what part of the scrollable box you can control with your finger. If you want to control a smaller part than the whole box, you can set the scroll area. It'll show up as this red square. So now this is the only part of the scrollable I can control with my finger. You will still control the whole box. You can also move this box around if you want to do that. I'm just going to go ahead and delete this so it's easier to see. The next step. Offset lets you move the inside up or down so that something that is off screen over here gets moved to the side so you can see it inside of the box. If we go in here and we make a text box, you can see this is barely on screen, but I want to move the inside of the box so that it starts over here. To do that, I go over here to the offset, and you can see it's now moving in, so I want to move it about 300 pixels so it's on the screen. If you want, you can hit center content, which means that it'll take the center of the box inside and move it so that it's centered. Zoom is if you want to be able to zoom inside of your scrollable boxes. The way this works is that you can set how much you can zoom out. If you want to set a base level of 1, which is just what you see when you get on the screen. You can do that. You can also go lower, so you can zoom out of that. You can set how much you want to zoom in. So now I'll be able to both zoom out and zoom in. And I can also change where I start. If I would still keep this one at 1, it'll start at 100%, not zoomed in or out. But I can start zoomed out if I want to do that. That's the most basic for scrollable boxes. You're most likely going to use scrollable boxes a lot, so I suggest that you just play around with them and get to know them and check out the other tutorials about scrollable boxes, namely scroll groups and parallaxing. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel to keep up to date with new tutorials, and have fun!